guest, Brandon Fobbs.
They matched.
Yes.
He is one of the stars of Pride, which was just released on DVD. It's a true story about Philadelphia's first African-American swim team. Yep. And, of course, we know you from The Wire.
Yes.
You're a busy guy.
Busy. Trying to stay busy. Trying to stay that way, definitely.
Trying to pay those bills.
Yeah,
and Brandon,
got
the door, you. A little later, everybody has a swim story.
We all have swim stories.
Oh, we all do. No.
I was on the swim team. I failed beginners.
No.
So there you go. That's my story.
You're probably the fastest.
We didn't say, did you greet our Hoppa? He's our DJ.
Yeah, we have Hoppa in the green room. What's up,
we go back.
Hours and hours ago.
Hoppa kept the green on.
We want to talk about this film because great cast, great story. Want to talk to you about that. But let's jump into some news.
Yeah. Well, you know, I'm thinking that technology is that the world's getting more technological as it is anyway. And technology now is built to more, you know, isolate you. It's built to more so you can do everything at home. So a lot of values are being left out where people are being like disgruntled about a lot of the systems in place. So I think that with that, you're going to be able to like inquire more people, even doctors or anybody that are disgruntled
with society. But you know, the thing about 9/11 that was so upsetting to me, I mean,
kind of like going to a Vegas casino where you know there's a camera at every angle.
Doesn't bother people in Vegas, though, does it? It doesn't bother people at all in Vegas.
Honestly, it doesn't bother me too much either. I mean, as long as you're not going to be doing anything bad.
As long as the restrooms are in my home.
The only problem is like the powers that be that are going to be in control. You never know who's controlling it, what agenda they got. So, you know, somebody can set up something against you. And somebody, if you are a political person, somebody speaking against the system, you never know. So they can frame you easily or whatever.
A lot of people were probably thinking, oh, it's big.
Oh, wow.
Isn't that interesting?
I say it was good, remember, because the guy that did that senseless murder the other time, where the old man was walking, he just hit him with the bat. You know, they were able to catch him.
And it's able to catch things as well.
It's that you have to balance that. You know, dichotomy. I don't want people necessarily knowing what I'm doing. But do you want to be safe, you know? And I think most of us want to be safe.
And then you want to be safe.
Hopefully the technology has...
How can you change it? Because then you think about the values that just... You know, if you could enhance values, I guess, then maybe you wouldn't need it because it's like treating the symptoms, but...
Good point.
How do you do it?
That's a very good point.
Well, I can have you here. Smart guy. This is good. Here's a story for you.
You might actually
be
too smart to be on the show.
if you could leave that. All right, imagine, this one's a little lighter. Imagine being able to...
I think it takes it back to the technology. Sitting down, everything is tailored to be able to do it right from a seat. You know, so.
Good point. Get up, move around a little.
Move around, do a little exercise.
Easy said from skinny guy over here.
Skinny guy number two.
Fit as a fiddle. All right.
But people like to dance on the edge nowadays.
Don't they?
Yeah, because, I mean, you can. You know, so they do what they can do.
How do you stop that?
Values. You know, how do you instill values? You start when you're teaching the kids, but... Now kids have grown up and they don't have values, you know?
You know what? A movie with good values is called Pride, and Terrence Howard is one of the stars, and of course it's just coming out on DVD. And this was sort of a true story that not a lot of people knew about, because I don't think that swimming, inherently there's a racial divide, but there weren't a lot of African-American swimmers.
Well, no, that's true. That's true, especially around that time. And even... When I was swimming in high school myself, I was one of maybe three on a team of maybe 20 or so, you know? So it's still not a popular sport, you know? A lot of people have a common saying, like, black folks don't swim or anything, but where I was raised, we were always in the pool, you know? I always see people swimming.
Did they cast you on the basis of that history you have with the swimming pool?
Yeah, because I came into the audition pretty cocky with it.
So you said, I can do a 100,
I came in there, I said, I can beat anybody you put in the pool with me.
All right.
And then,
How about that?
Knowing that I haven't swam since high school. You know?
Okay, what's funny is we're going to get, all right, everybody here, and then Hopper, you can kick in if you got one. All right, very quickly, a good swimming story. What is your personal swim story?
All right, so one time at a swim meet, my mother, she was videotaping the race. It was a 200. That's 8 laps. And when we were swimming, she was going after the whole meet. I was watching the videotape, and I'm watching her taping, and she's like, "That's okay, baby. That's all right. It's all right." And I already finished, so she ended up taping somebody else that lost. Because
I was that somebody else. I went to Uni High, which is in West LA, but we swam at Beverly High.
Okay.
Beverly High has the basketball court that opens up, and there's the pool inside.
Yeah.
So the very first meet that I was in, and you know this, when you're last, they go on the loudspeaker, swimmer in the water, so they don't start the next race.
Right.
Oh.
Yeah.
Voila.
Oh no.
That's funny. I was pretty much close to
to that too. When I was on the swim team, the only meet and the last meet that my father came to watch, I was doing the 50 and I went 25 freestyle, 25 I was first. Mm. Coming back the last 25 I was last, and my dad was so disappointed and he never came back.
My swim story, I swam on the Crawford swim team in California, in San Diego. Mike Stamm won the gold medal with Mark Spitz in the Olympics, so we had a terrific swim team. But I did the butterfly, and on the back end of my 100-meter butterfly stroke, I started losing my swimsuit, Speedo. Oh. And, you know, if you break, I won the race, but I was DQ'd because I broke stroke. I didn't continue the stroke, and so I was like yanking on it.
Oh, jeez.
Now we had that in the movie.
Yeah. See, that happens, and so you get DQ'd, you don't win.
And I'm apparently the only one here who couldn't swim as a child. So we'll just move back to you, Brandon. Tell us more.
No stories about you in the water at all.
Since
Carlos brought up the Speedo thing in the movie, which received wonderful notices, and Terrence Howard is so great opposite Brett. Look at this clip about swimsuits, oddly enough.
What we're gonna do, we're gonna go inside the locker room, we're gonna put on the swim gear.
Swim gear, coach, I got my shorts on under my pants. Yeah,
me too, I got
No, you're not prepared. Today we're gonna wear the real thing. Elson?
What are you talking about? One side fit all.
No.
Hell no.
I'm not wearing that. That ain't funny.
What do you mean, hell no? This is a swim meet, this isn't some backyard function. This is proper swimming attire. This is your uniform.
That's not my uniform.
Elston, come on now. I can't even get my boys in those.
Trust me, you and your boy will be just fine.
Right back there as well. That just looks like, did you guys have fun making it?
We had a great time. We had a blast. We were on there swimming, learning, meeting new people, having a great time.
But it's tough to film always underwater, isn't it? I mean, that's what a lot of actors talk about. It's talking about filming all the time.
They had some awesome equipment. You saw some camera action where they started from under the water,
right,
and then came right on out. It was like nice circular waterproof camera. It was awesome. I saw some technology I've never seen before.
Talk about the importance of making this film and telling this story. I imagine it connected to something in you.
Yeah, it connected to taking pride in yourself, you know, because like a lot of times young black youth, you know, a lot of times we learn to laugh a lot of things off, you know, not take things seriously, even things that need to be taken seriously. So one particular scene in there I loved when, you know, Terrence and Bernie, they got on us about laughing off the swim meet that we just flubbed up terribly. So, you know, there's things that you do take seriously. It's okay to laugh. Laugh is great for your health. But sometimes, you know, you got to buckle down, qualify yourself, and be mad if you don't do well, you know. Mm-hmm. Right.
Brandon comes back another time to talk all about The Wire and to share with us his journal that he made.
What?
Actually a journal I used in the movie, and it's my real journal. It's called Sit Rep, a situation report. I got that from a video game. So it's
what prompted you to do that?
Huh? Well, just actor choice, bringing in yourself to your character so you know, write down everything. And I got more in here, just ideas for different things.
Good for you.
Really?
How cool.
Excellent.
Yeah.
I got like three of these things.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I'm
We're going to look at volumes 1, 2, and 3. And Crawl's on DVD right now. Great cast, really good reviews. This is really fun, Brandon. Come back.
Hey,
thanks a lot. Thanks so much.
I had a great time with
everybody. By the way, I can swim now because I know you're worried about me.
I'm holding classes.
Okay.
Good. Yeah, and my dad did come back, by the way. I'm sorry, Dad.
And Brandon's the only one on the set right now that could wear a Speedo. So,
yeah. No.
He doesn't have to get
I'm sure you could.
Trust me.